change what we done. It made us who we are today. I'm taking every chance I get to make it so you won't forget who we are.
Hello. Ooh, okay, that's a little too loud. Hello. Remember we hello. To the corner of 69. Yeah, they will come chasing us. We find a new place to hide. Making our plans to break out. Give me your hand and they will know who we are. Never be us. Hello. This is going to be the Columbus Cottonmoths. They used to be a team in Columbus, Georgia, where I'm originally from. the SBHL, but they're all in the dark. Souls at the crossroads, your sins I'm forgiven. You're gonna take that dark old. You wanna dig in the earth? I used to be from Columbus. I live in Tennessee now. My flame's gonna hurt. Are you ready for the devil, man? I was born in Columbus, moved to Tennessee 11 years ago. Okay, that's not too far. Pass through there when I go home to see grandparents. Yeah, that's kind of what I was going for Columbus. So. Here's a final straw to take a stride. And I write direction, I can hardly see the sky. Cover in this lonely path, nothing's built to last. I can know, oh, say. See what that looks like. It's actually more of a dark blue. Yeah, that looks good. I actually have a Columbus Cottonmoths jersey that I used to have hanging on my wall back there, but we just moved, and so haven't been able to get it up to the new house yet. Actually, I think I'll go grab it real quick for a second. Signed by the whole team on it, you'll see the signatures on there. trying to do the alternate stuff and like that.
Sleeping,
those diplomacies. Yeah, it is. That's why I picked on it, because it looked like it. Fire seems a little dangerous though. Yeah, I think about that. most important is always the goal for it. Maybe they would have the Nashville song. Yeah, that's a classic song. Back and forth, cheap endings, let's be friends, hummingbird. Verano Exchange. Because I'm still playing MLB. Enter GM name. If you see something, see a certain play you want or a certain team, let me know. I'll see what I can do. Definitely want to get the best goalie available out here. So you know by chance who's got the top goalies available in the draft here at Circle. Malcolm Subban, I like it up for Vegas this year. Smith's gonna be bad, but he's too old, too much money. Pretty decent backup, medium elite. He only got 1 year left to go, so. Toronto's goalie? Sparks? No. He's a little too old, I think. Worried about these guys that only have 1 year left. Worried about not being able to negotiate with them afterwards. Alright, let's go also. I do think I'm going to pick Ekholm, solid defenseman, locked up for 6 years, not much of a contract, pretty good everywhere, all around, shooting's pretty great, power's pretty good, still saying playing MLB. Definite scores. A lot of good defensemen out here. Really young guys. Not opposed to taking old guys, but I'd rather. You know, get guys probably 26 and then you bring up the place.
start.
Solid Hutchinson here. He's only 27, so he's not super cool. He's only got a 1 year contract for 2 years.
Turn your back, you're a broken man. They come around and just die in the shade of your head. Don't expect you to understand. Just keep telling yourself there's no shame. They don't know about who we are. They don't know about you and I. They ain't all blind by the stars of your eyes. Oh, hot blood, love is gonna get you. And get up again, get up
spend too much on the defense here. Maybe not really solid defense here. And I definitely do like having a new solid play. Good defense. Shot blocking. I'm kind of receiving the next year on my two sheets a week. Yeah, I think I will go with that. Pretty much lock up our defense, top two line on the D.
Some new viewers up here. If you, you guys have any particular players or teams you want to look at, just let me know. We'll see what we can get from them. This is my first time doing an expansion draft, so don't really know how well the team's going to be in the first couple of years, but we'll see what we can do. Hopefully we can draft some pretty high talent that can produce for us.
Thank you.
reasonable centers there, not getting all this overplay. Marco Testu, not bad, 85 base off, moving off the older side, but it's not too bad for him. I might go with one for test you, but I can't find anybody else. You need to get it to little goalies here. Until the end, you wouldn't be a solid backup. I think it's just a little too long for me right now. I never was a lonely drifter, slow rain. I live for the money now. I never was afraid to speak my mind. Oh, baby's got a babysitter. I think I'm still up. Yeah. Stack up the money now. I'd rather be a hustler than a clown. When the world will be polluted by the ashes of the sun, ain't nobody gonna tell me where to run. If there is a God, she probably wants me to explore the universe. And if life is just a ride, it should be fun. And the air is free. Keep going back to his homes here. It's kind of hard to pass up on an elite potential goalie. I think I want to get there. Maybe we'll go center and I drop him. I've got my two goalies. I'm a bit centered there. Maybe I'm a one-trick pony, but I ride it, honey. Maybe I'm a master of the skies. When the world will be polluted by the ashes of the sun, ain't nobody gonna tell me where to run. Oh, quite a bit. You think about a third of the cap space, so about a third of the team, so you can go like that. Dallas. First round pick, 11. 73 overall would definitely be a fourth line. And now, it seems like we have the contract to a 24. Yeah, I'll take a chance on it. See what happens. Right wing here. Let's just go down the list and see what we got for the right wingers. Top nine forward. Okay. Tyler. Pretty good shooting here. 25. Top nine down to top 9 forward versus top 6 forward. Look at their stats, both of them. Their career. Giving out pretty solid mid-20s. Low 30 points overall. Pick over half the teams, a little bit over half of our cap space left, so we'll be able to splurge and get another solid defenseman here. Definitely more defenseman. May go with a little bit of Lucy Yelkin as well. 34, a little bit older than my. Justin Brown, not bad. He's driving for sure. Six million though, a little bit. A little expensive. It was 6 years though, so we would have him for the rest of his career unless we end up trading him for some reason. Bottom six, a little bit cheaper. I had him for 4 years though. Clifford. Just due to the fact he's got 4 years already on his contract, we'll have to negotiate with him at the end of the season. For now, yeah, I think we will go with Clifford. I'm not sure. All 80s. Not bad there. We're looking at these two guys here, the two bottom six forwards. Seeing which one of these guys we were gonna pick. I think they're virtually about the same center versus right wing, both at 380 position. Stats are virtually the same. Not much difference overall between the two. I think I will just go with Quickly because he's locked up for longer than I can. So, go there. Florida. Florida's not got much to keep from here. I'm going to get some form of prospect which NHL guys are going to help out the team anytime soon. He's a little old, 36. We have 3 years left. There's 1.2 million contracts. I do want to leave some space in the cap. That way we can potentially sign maybe a free agent or two, maybe do some trading if we need to. But as of now, we've got quite a bit left. Over half the team is picked. We have over half the cap space left, which is nice. So maybe we can just trade. Jacob Kendall. I think we've got pretty much our defense locked up. We do need 9, so we're going to have to pick somebody at some point for the team. Petrovic, not too bad, you know. A solid slot shot power, good shot power. Defense is pretty good. 1 year on the contract, median top 16. I never changed what we done. I think we will love. It made us who we are today. Older though, we haven't, I would assume until he retires at 34 in 5 years, 35. Which will be a chunk down to 1 year. The end of 1 year. So it's probably a little bit cheaper in the long haul. Probably going to perform somewhere around the same level, maybe a little bit less. I think I will get the situation. We do need to start on looking at a third goalie at some point. It's definitely not going to be anybody that has a lot of talent. Remember we used to run. Just a lot would be too bad. 3 years on a very cheap contract, two-way, 77 overall. That's what I'm looking for in the backup. Maybe third string. Make sure they don't have anybody else. Bowie leads. That's always good. 83 overall, 22 years old. Does have a pretty hefty contract, but he is locked up for 5 years. They have to go with him. Obviously, he can be another solid defenseman that will take up quite a bit of cap space, but Lowry, definitely need to start and got chewed up some of his cap. I already have 60, so yeah, we will work with the whole brother. Islanders. But we could say we had to have 9 defensemen, 3 goalies.
Okay, alright.
Mickey. Not too bad on the contract, it is locked up for 6. I think I actually will go with Clutterbuck here, right winger. That'll fill out our right wings, our wingers. I do definitely like that contract.
No mercy, no mercy.
We've got 10 spots left at $34 million. That averages out to $3.4 million a piece.
Put the ghost in the graveyard.
Go Clutterbuck.
Gonna make that Rangers. Fire rain. No mercy, no mercy. Take honey from the hornet's nest. I'm a bullet in the barrel.
Solid defense, but that would be one for 2 years. So we've filled our right wing.
You wanna play in the flames? My flame's gonna hurt. Are you ready for the devil, man?
That gives us 3 spots to go over.
Are you ready for the devil?
So,
are you ready for the devil, man?
Good to go.
Are you ready for the devil?
Right wing, at least. Pretty good shooting ability.
You wanna dig in your
rear stats.
You wanna play in the flames. My flame's gonna hurt. Are you ready for the devil, man?
14.
Are you ready for the devil, man? Are you ready for the devil? Are you ready for the devil, man? Are you ready for the devil?
Just with bats, dude. Pretty much fill out our right wingers to pick Matthias Ekholm from Nashville first, just because I wanted to see who we could get from my Nashville Predators here. There's really nobody else here that I would be interested in. Kelly Onkwe, solid right winger, was locked up for 6 years on a pretty solid $2 million contract. Top-line forward.
Are you ready for the devil, man?
He would be probably my next pick if I had to pick him. Probably solid. But I'm going to definitely pick him. I'm going to love Joy. Here's 3 years on his contract. Need 2 more defensemen. Devils definitely have a plethora of defensemen here that they are willing to give up. If not, it's going to be a right winger. That's pretty much all they have is D-man and left winger. So both of those positions we've already filled out pretty well with the players we've picked already. We definitely will have to go with them. Hummingbird,
do you feel anything, hummingbird?
$1.3 million.
back and forth. Cheap endings, let's be friends. Powerful looking type guy. He definitely looks a little bit bigger than the and average. I feel like a stranger. Average right winger. Every time I lay you down. Yeah, third liner. Maybe I'll expect the top two for us. That pick there is Smith Elliott. I see anybody else that I would be interested in. I think I will go with Smith Elliott from the New Jersey Devils. He goes with 7 picks left. He will go to third goalie. Yep, I think we will go with Carlson here from the San Francisco to Ottawa. Let's check out their numbers. We need to pick a third before the end of the draft here. It would be a solid second goalie. I actually really go with all the Cottonmoths. I think we will do this. Cottonmoths. 31, a little bit older than I would like, but he will definitely be our second string. Let's see what Ottawa has to offer. We need one more center, two more defensemen, and a left wing to fill out our minimum. We have 5 picks left. We have 4 necessary positions to leave us.
But you don't know who you are. The road's gonna take you, make you walk too far.
Alright, let's see who Ottawa is offering. You could be a center winger. Zingle? He's American, surprisingly. Lama, he's a Canadian. We need some more centers. 25, so he's too old. had some pretty good success in the NHL in his 2 years he was there. 36 points in 44 games, not too bad. Never be a slave to your own name. Is evil. 7 years long. You're a poet, you're a fake, you're a star. You don't know who you are. We can shine a light here inside the dark and get a little closer. Solid defenseman for us here. Pretty good contract for 2 years. 78 overall. Good stats. 43 points in 60 games in the AHL in 14. Not too much success in the NHL. Definitely racked up the penalty minutes. Over 2 a game, 3 a game there. NHL, tone it down once again to the NHL. Like the stars are rolling. Do you like Brandon Manning? Stars are rolling. On track, 2 years. Lately, I've been feeling. That's all I really see. But the stars are rolling out for me. Stars are rolling. To everybody's favorite team, the Pittsburgh Penguins. Not a big fan of them, but we'll see who we see from. Yeah. You were just a kid with a sentimental heart, and do it for yourself, and do it for the art. But you don't need the baggage, you don't need the stuff, and you don't need nobody. Chris Kunitz. They have the same contract, Percy and the water. Defensemen are not going to have the greatest shooting ability. Percy almost needs that. Stats are pretty much the same, passing, same age and everything. Both Colados, because he's a year older. And then we already had Carlson, Hunt, selected from the Sharks and Blues. Austin of the Bay, we need to get the best winger. Let's see. Has the better of the left wingers. Not going to be from hopefully going to have something better to offer. Brendan Hines. Eric. But I had come to see that.
Alright, that leaves us with the Tampa Bay Lightning. It was be our last pick in the expansion draft here, so we will see who I believe it said the minimum cap was $50 million. I believe that is what it said. We used to talk until the sun came out. We used to walk. Just didn't say anything here about the cap. I believe that was the if somebody with a little bit of cap space here. Either way, we're going to have about $25 million left over in cap space to do what we wish. So, let's see. I think we're going to have to go with Braden Coburn here. I know we already have some pretty solid defenseman to play with. So I mean, there's our top six right there. Pretty young guys, and as you can tell, most of my money in the defenseman here. Lightly. We've got some guys with some good potentials. But I think we will do just fine. A lot of good potential in these top three here. Potential good potential from McNeil here. We could either go with a center or a left winger, whichever one we pass the picks from. I think I'm going to go with Paquette here. Leave it played now, so it's not very good on the name side. And that will finish our team. We can finish the draft. Sure, you want to submit your draft picks. This is not the undraft. Okay. I believe we should be okay. So there is our team. Looking forward to see what these guys can do. It's walking. Curious to see how well these guys can do in their first season. The way I plan on doing this is obviously it would take forever to play the full 82 game season. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to sim the games that are not division games, and the division games I will play myself. So against the Central Division, those are the teams I will be playing. If you have a particular team that you want to see me play, we can do that as well. But as of now, what I plan on doing is playing against the Central Division opponents with the other games. Points leadership team. Obviously, these points were not with us, but Shattenkirk leading the way with 56 points. Nobody on the team, high goal scorer, maybe
maybe should have addressed that a little bit better. Top goal scorer on the team with 14 goals from Dzingel. But I think we should be fine. These guys with their AHL teams, I believe that would be. It is the AHL guys. Don't believe I need any of these guys on the NHL team. For now, we should move up there. The Aces is going to be on our AHL team. So let's switch this back over to the NHL. Let's see. Players to build around. We'll see what we go from there. Okay. We can check out the trading block. I don't believe there's going to be anybody that we would be wanting to trade. These are obviously not picks. Obviously, nobody on the team high trade potential. I don't really see anybody here that might be good to trade. TSF call potential could trade now. It's a pretty good trade value. We already have a solid defensive core. But I think for now, I think we're just going to leave everything as is. We will get the NHL entry draft over with. Not sure where we are going to be picking. Here is our draft class that we have to go with. Draft Elite for Peterson. The Swede would not be enough. We are obviously not here. Okay, yeah. We do have the potential of picking him if he is not sent to user pick. And he was chosen second overall by the Kings. Nico Hischier went first overall. And we are on the clock, so I'm going to go ahead and make our pick. I don't really have a particular position or anything that I want to go with. I do like Yamamoto. Would not be a bad pick overall. Don't really see anybody else that I want. Wish I could remember who the Predators do you think we will take Kyle Yamamoto or our pilot Yamamoto with our first pick? Medium top 6
scouted top six forward, playmaker. Stats, he's a top six forward, 18 years old, 16 years old, that could be a little bit hard, but you know, you can't really expect much. So the Islanders are offering their fourth round pick this year. Yes, yes. Their fourth and fifth for our fourth. And I do believe I'm going to take that. Just the fact, even though the pick is going to be about 13 picks later, we're going to get the second player in the fifth round, three picks later, so I will accept that trade, and we still pick third overall, just out of curiosity, would like to see who the Predators pick. So the Golden Knights did get Suzuki. Sim to next pick, and again, just out of curiosity, see who the Predators chose. Second-class pick, and they chose Nathan Schmard, not that. Canada, get some solid goalies here. I was just thinking that we should probably go with a goalie that we can have down in the AHL, getting some reps in. Reflex is not too good. Sweetland here, Tyler Sweetland. Sort of goalies.
will draft Leighton my next pick. Wong would not be bad at defense. I'd like to have a solid defenseman down in the NHL getting some reps. If you go with Russell Wong, so 7 points. Defenseman is currently a medium top 4D, so that's pretty sweet. A little bit better than scouted. Right now, not too good. 52 overall stats, not very good. But you know, he will develop down in the minors. Hoping that Leighton is still here. He's the third one left. A little bit more. He might be selected between now and our next pick. When is our next pick? Third overall in the next round, so not too far to go. Only about 15 picks out, but I do want to for sure go ahead and lock him up, Leighton. I do like him a lot. He's a solid goalie who's been highly scouted, rated as a backup, good reflexes, very athletic, decent control. I think we would go ahead. Medium backup, 57 overall, defenses and athletic, not as good as scouted, but hopefully he can turn into somebody a little bit better in the future. Alright, now send to our next pick, which is the third overall pick in the fifth round. A low elite pick in the fifth round. This was very good there from the Avalanche. So let's now see who we can get in the fifth round here. The 131st overall pick. I don't really have any particular positions in mind that I feel like drafting. Our defense is obviously very good in the NHL. Medium 7th defenseman, 154 overall. Should be able to get some decent stuff going on there with the AHL. Good slot shot power, good shot power. Not very good on the accuracy, but that will play. mean you should have another bit in the fifth round? Yes. Trades. Nobody spectacular. Medium top nine forward. Another low elite. Wow, lots of low elites picked here in the fifth round. Hopefully I can get some of that draft luck and get somebody who it will be for. Philip Howden, potential medium top nine forward. They say he will be a top nine forward. Has been very highly scouted by our team. And his name is Sasha, yeah. Decent centerman for us. He's a low top nine forward. Currently 56 overall. Round 6, where we have the third overall pick of the 6th round. As you can see, we drafted a left winger, 2 defensemen, a goalie, and a center, and then Yamamoto not on the screen there. Not sure where he's at, but now we can pick it. There is not anybody that catches my eye here. May just try and trade the pick for another pick later in the draft or potentially for next year that we could use in some trades if we do that. I do think I like this guy, Durzi, from Canada, Sean Durzi. Been scouted 3 times in the OHL. Looks to be a pretty decent pick for the 6th round, so I will pick Durzi. He's an AHL top 2, so you never know. May develop into a low 60s, maybe high 60s if we're lucky, and then maybe get some time in the NHL if we have a player down with it. So that was our 6th round pick. Golden Knights right behind us, and there again at 7. On to the 7th round. Giving him a high top 9, but he has not been scouted twice in the
believe that's the Finnish name from Finland. I'm leaning between Art 2, Rokasalini. No, that's not how you pronounce that. The Finnish left winger. He's been scouted twice. May go with Roberts instead, just because they gave him the exact bottom six forward. He's been scouted three times already, so I know a little bit more about him. So, got less than a minute here on the clock. I think we will go with the Finnish left winger. Mega with the Finnish right winger instead. No, I haven't been scouting very much. Go with the Finnish left winger. A medium bottom six winger, so not a bad pick. Already 61 overall. Should be able to do some pretty decent stuff down in the AHL. He's got very good skating ability, already 3.5 stars. He needs to work on his shooting a little bit if he's going to be a winger. But we'll see what we can do. Yeah. I believe that should be it for our drafting. Yes. So we will now send the user pick. That should send us to the end of the draft. So there you have it. There is our drafted players: Kyle Yamamoto, Strom, Wong, Leighton, Noel, Krembelski, Jersey, and the Finnish left winger.
Turn your back, you're a broken man. They come around and just die and shake your head.
With all of those guys should go straight to the AHL. They may end up going to their league. So I have 8 skaters that are going to become restricted free agents, including Bosher, no goalies, which is good. You need to tender qualifying offers to secure negotiating rights with them.
You're the better man. You wanna reach for the things that nobody can. All you need is to break away, yeah. Just keep telling yourself there's no shame. They don't know about who we are. They don't know about you and I. They ain't all blind by the stars of your eyes.
So hot blood love is gonna get out. So Shattenkirk is an unrestricted free agent, so we definitely need to get him back, and he's going to be one of our top defensemen on the team, so definitely want to secure him for a long time. Now he only wants 2 years, $5 million. I'll bump it up to 5.1. Just in hopes, actually I'll go up to 5.45, and just to give him a little bit of cushion, which he gets a little bit of cushion. That's what we're going to offer to him. We'll get back to us tonight. Hutchinson here, who will be our starting goaltender.
in the NHL. Wanted to definitely keep a hold of him. He has some medium top six potential, so he could be pretty good pick for our team in the coming years. 2.425, I'll put up just a little bit, 2 years of running back, so not too bad. I'll see if I can get him on 2, and he does want a little bit more money in case, so we'll add that just a little bit in case he chooses not to. And so, Zingle here. Medium top 9 forward, asking for 3 years, I'm okay with that, and I'll bump that up to 1.8. He is interested in a 2-way back then. I would like to keep him for 2 years if I could. Can't even offer him that much. It looks like it's gonna have to be a 1-year contract as a 2-way contract, and we'll see what he has to say about it. Not interested in a 2-way here, so I think he will stay with the NHL team. 1.35, that is. So bump that at 1.75, 1.7. And I'll get back on track. Get back on track. Alright, now we definitely do want to sign Pitlick here, high top line forward potential. Gonna be a good player for the team here in a few years. Already 76 overall. See if we can get him to go for 2 years. So once we get the money, that's alright. We have plenty of that. And can we get it for 3? Yeah. That's a little bit more money. So we're gonna get I'll see if I can get him for 4 years. That'll lock him up to 29, and hopefully by then he has some pretty high overall with the team and some good stats. So we'll go with 4 year here. 1.3 million is what he's asking. 325. Just make things a little bit better for him. Who else? He is interested in the 2-way, which is good. I do want to send him down to the minors, get some playing time in, and hopefully build up those stats. We'd like to go ahead and sign him up for 3 years. We're going to do 2, knock him up for his 25. A little bit more than he's asking, so hopefully he won't select us. All right, now I'm starting to see the guys who we drafted pop up here. Hopefully we can sign all of them to pretty good contracts. And we can keep them around for a long time and see them develop. So here is Yamamoto. He was the top draft pick for us. Was $9.25 million. I'm perfectly fine with that. He won 3 years. I wanted to do a two-way contract. Let's get that done. Good news is it appears all the rookies want 3 year contracts, which is definitely what I want from them. I want to keep them around for a long time, see them throughout their development, and then make sure that we can use them in the NHL. Submitted contracts to all of the available players here. Not sure what we still have this explanation for people under the owner category. So now we're going to sim a day or two. We'll sim you up to this day. Info accepted, pickup accepted, pitch pitch accepted, pass accepted, single. Shattenkirk declined. Ooh, that's not good. May have to go after him in free agency in order to see if we can get him back, because I definitely want him on the team. He was the leading point getter players. Here's our rookies. They all accepted their contract. Let's go back and see if we can get Shattenkirk. So he's not here anymore. He's the points leader. See if we add some items just to tilt on Yamamoto. Talk to Yamamoto, went to the CHL, which is fine. Get some good development in there. Shattenkirk with the AHL for some reason. Not sure why he's there. Let's go ahead and just add some draft picks here. So we only have a couple picks like that. And add our third, fourth, and fifth round picks to the trading block. In hopes that maybe somebody could throw a trade out there and we can get somebody good in return for that. It's actually going to throw up my second, third, and fourth. In hopes that maybe somebody can offer us just a little bit of a flare, a better flare. I'm just going to have it set prices or something. I don't know why we're selling Shattenkirk jerseys. He wants to do for me. Sim another day. pending free agents, can we offer Shaq more money? No, okay, that's not the right category. Well, there he is. He's one of the top. One of the top free agents, as well as Yager. I would like to pick up Yager just because I'm a huge Yager fan. He's also very good. So if we could pick him up, $4 million is a lot of money. But you never know, we may be able to get the legend. Here's Shattenkirk. He wants a little bit more money, is what he said, I believe. So I'll go to 5.2. Actually, I'll go to 5.25 just because I really want him back on the team. He was the leading point getter of the players who we selected. So I'm going to go ahead and offer him that contract. I believe there's a couple more who declined. Who will offer just a little bit more money to the coach that they can stick with us. The rest of these guys. So Chiasson has still rejected, says maybe more cash could persuade me. I think the most I'd be willing to go on him for $2 million, and Shattenkirk still rejected the contract. So I'm going to try one, maybe two more times on those guys and see if we can get either of them to stay with us. So I'm going to bump it up to 5.35. That would probably be my max. I'm going to try and go at him for 3 years, and I'll go 5.5 million. Very expensive, but he is a very good top four defenseman who will definitely produce for us. So 3 years, 5.5 million. Hopefully, we can get him. One more here. I'll go $2 million on him and see what we can do there. Is this Parker Day? It's upcoming. Signed free agents. So free agency starts in a couple days. So we need to see still rejected and rejected again. I will try one more time on both of them, and if I can't get them in, then I'm just going to have to let them walk, unfortunately. I really was hoping to be able to get Shattenkirk, but if I can't, then maybe we'll have to pick up somebody from the NBA. So last time I offered him 3 years, 5.5 million, I believe it was. I'll stick with the 2 years that he's asking, and maybe that will help him. So let's offer him that, even though it is less money, it is the amount of years he wants. I think I'm just gonna let Chiasson walk. And we can definitely pick up somebody in free agency. I talked about maybe getting Yager Yager. So that money could go, the money that would go towards Chiasson and signing him will go towards the Yager signing. May not be Yager, may go for somebody else. So I'm just going to go ahead and release him. I think that's an option here. Just release him. So won't be getting him to sign another contract with us. I'm going to go ahead and send one more day in hopes that Shattenkirk accepts our offer. Still rejected it, so
probably just going to have to let him walk, which is going to be very unfortunate. He definitely would have been the top liner on the D with Matthias Ekholm. Maybe got Fred. We're typically pending defenseman free agents. Quite a few good ones here. Shakhtar at the top of that list. So it looks like Jágr actually was able to sign a contract with the team that he had because he's not an upcoming free agent anymore. So there is some good defensemen I see down through here. None as good as Shakhtar, but you never know. I believe that is it on the players in chat group here. I'm going to try one more time. I really don't want to, but 5.65 million, and see if maybe that will tempt him to stick with the Cottonmoths through the upcoming season. So we're going to go ahead and sim one more day to the start of the agency, and he's still rejected. So I'm just going to have to let him walk, unfortunately. He would have been a top liner for us. I have a bigger friend now. Okay, well, let's make sure. I don't think I want any of these guys on the trade block. Well, you know what? I think I will leave them up there. My goal is 29, 30, 30. I will leave them on here. Maybe somebody will offer us some good picks for them. So now it should be 3 agents. Sign three. I believe. Yeah, sign 3 agents. So let's go to. I'm going to go to the bathroom real quick and be right back.
I just had to.
Yeah, we are on the NHL 18. My phone was just messing up and hadn't updated. So yeah, we're all good to go there. I'm gonna leave this open. Just minimize and go here. And I think I'm actually going to end the stream here. Thank you for the couple people who came out and watched. And I will be back playing some of the games.